Aquarius, Amanda here. Hi, welcome to Unseen Hands Healing. This is your small story reading. So this reading is perhaps more of a glimpse, more of an insert into a moment that you may be experiencing, as opposed to the larger monthly shift energies that went out at the beginning of October. So this is a really interesting energy. For these readings, books have been wanting to fly off the shelf, and this one was like, ding, 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 get this book off the shelf. And I was surprised because I'm like, really? Like, you know, I had it in my human head that something more narrative might be more exciting. But let me tell you what has come out of this Practical Guide to Vibrational Medicine book. All right, classic Richard Gerber manual here, the Bible to all things energy healing. There's a chapter on the art of healing with flower essences. And this part in specific is talking about, like, how does this actually work in theory? And it goes like this, Aquarius. Flower essences contain a kind of liquid tincture of the plant's life force energy, in addition to the healing energetic patterns possessed by the plant. The flower is the crowning achievement of the plant, containing the highest concentration of its life force energy. After all, the flower is the site at which most plants are pollinated and are able to reproduce. When a flower essence is produced using the sun method, the pranic energy of sunlight transfers or imprints a small amount of the life force energy's pattern into the water. I think that's the important part for you, this imprinting of a life force pattern. In some ways, this is analogous to making an old-fashioned sun print by placing a leaf on photosensitive paper and exposing the paper to bright sunlight. By bathing the sun-exposed photo paper in developer solution, a photographic image of the plant leaf which lay upon the paper is quickly revealed. Similarly, the energy of sunlight is able to make a kind of etheric imprint of a plant's flower in water. The water does not actually contain medicinal molecules taken from the flower. Instead, it contains a subtle energy pattern that can produce profound effects in human beings if appropriately prescribed for various medical and emotional conditions. And he goes on to talk about how Bach believed that, Bach flower essences, okay, believed that this works on the level of the spiritual body, okay, the least dense vibration of our existence. If the physical body is the most dense, the spiritual body would be, you know, the etheric body would be the least dense. And that's the level on which this imprint exists. We are going to pull cards, Aquarius, don't worry. But when I sat with this, I read this passage and I was like, I was caught on this spiritual imprint. There's a spiritual pattern imprinted. And I was just like, oh my God, what is this? Okay, so I sat with it for a bit and I started getting all of these, just like this flood, because the feeling of it was so big for you. And I started getting all of these images of like the secret world of Alex Mack, okay, if anyone, his 90s child. All right, the secret world of Alex Mack, and ghostwriters. And images of invisible ink. And you know that thing when you write on a notepad and the person takes the top sheet off, if you rub in pencil all along, the imprint of the writing that came before will be revealed. It's like something being, some sort of invisible imprint being revealed in the physical. Some invisible spiritual imprint, Aquarius. And then, okay, so I pulled some cards preliminarily, just being like, oh my God, I'm having so many feelings about this, like, imprint. What is this about? Flower essence imprint. Like, how beautiful. And then these are the cards that came out. water and attachment, and I felt immediately something about an emotional imprint. There's like an emotional attachment or like spiritual, because this can, water can be emotional, it can be intuitive, it can be that like unconscious realm. There's something here, Aquarius, about an unseen imprint, like a spiritual unconscious imprint. I think attachment is like the only card in the deck that could speak to that word, imprint. And I saw this as, you know, out of the group, there is the imprint of one that crosses your heart and like sticks right there at the base of your sternum, which is just like an incredible attachment point for so many of your intrinsic core muscles and fascia, connective tissue. It's like, it's this central, very sensitive point in the body. And that is where this is placed, this, the imprint, the emotional, spiritual imprint of this one thing on you. I'm like, what the hell? And then my ears started buzzing. My ears did a buzzing thing when there's like, when I'm, you know, Nancy Drew sleuthing, I'm like onto something. And so I was like, there's more. And it was like literally like playing the hot cold game with me. It's like, you're getting warm, you're getting warmer, you're getting hot. Oh, you're boiling. And it was like, ding, ding, ding. When I came over to this book, it's gonna be so big, I hope you can see. Okay. And look what it says, the invisible universe. What is this word invisible that keeps coming in to this reading for you? We're already at 7 minutes. Like, screw it. This is just gonna be this whole in-depth thing. Aquarius, these are supposed to be small stories. I should have known better than to try to make them small. Okay. So this is the page out of this book that I was drawn to. Oh Lord. Okay, hold on. I'm coming. There we go. Can you see? Look at the beauty. Oh my God, the glare. Look at this gorgeous gold dust, stardust freaking cluster. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in and I'm not gonna be able to see, but I hope it's focused. I want you to see the majesty. I'm like peeking through like a creep. Okay. Incredible. Oh my God. Okay. And then I was drawn to this passage. So this is called an open star cluster. This is an open star cluster. And this is in the constellation Sagittarius, which I think is important. And then there's a quote from Plato down here, and it says, "And after having thus framed the universe, he allotted to it souls in equal number to the stars, inserting each in each. And he declared also that after living well for the time appointed to him, each one should once more return to the habitation of his associate star and spend a blessed and suitable existence." Oh my God. Okay. So we're talking about having an associate star, which feels like, out of all the stars in this cluster here, to which, you know, there is, you know, if we all come from stars, if we are stars, you know, this concept of star seed, and this looks like a seed, so that's interesting. If for example, Aquarius, this is the particular star cluster that you come from, your like associate star is here, imprinted at the central part of you. It's freaking gorgeous. Okay, I'm a deeply romantic being, so this is just like giving me heart palpitations. 10 minutes, let's get into a reading for you. I almost like don't even know where to start because this feels so gigantic. Freaking Aquarians gotta be up in space. Okay, let's just ground it. I'm gonna go to the next world, as I've been doing with these readings, and just see what comes out. Okay, give it a couple shuffles here. What is this mega massive reading about for Aquarius? What is coming through? Okay, being told to cut the deck. This reading kind of has me flying by the seat of my pants. I'm feeling like I'm having to trust so much. Because I don't know what this is about, you know? Like, I don't know what I'm doing. Okay. Interesting. Okay, we have the Ace of Swords. The Ace of Swords, the roots of action. There's something here. It's like this is a realization, the Ace of Swords, that wants to come through. Because I'm getting with the Four of Pentacles, you know, there's something here about your toolkit, maybe your intuitive toolkit, Aquarius. Y'all are like mentally so equipped and your minds are just like in the higher space. You know, for many of you. And so I'm seeing this like swords, mental space, having this vast toolkit. Look at all of the tools at your disposal here, Aquarius. And even here, it's like here you are in your studio, in your lab, in your tool room, doing your work. And this all feels very spiritual work. Because of the flower essences, the way we started, and then the stars. I'm like, oh my God. So here you are doing your spiritual work, you know? You're in the lab. You're in the tapped into the mainframe is actually what I'm seeing this as, some sort of mainframe. You're tapped into the mainframe. Using your toolkits, and out of this being tapped in, this idea, this lightning bolt, this realization is coming to you about this imprint, whatever this is, this energetic thing or person or part of you or something that has this deeply spiritual energetic imprint on you. It's like this comes through in the form of a spiritual download. And I'm saying that here, and it's like launching you into a freaking, like, you're on another planet. You're like traveling astrally, maybe spiritually, to another planet, like the planet of your, I'm feeling like home, a lot of home energy, like that imprint on your soul where it's like that thing is home. The messenger, yeah, okay? The messenger, AKA the Hierophant. But for here, I think this, the key here is that a message is coming through some sort of like literal platform, some sort of like platform being the vehicle for the, oh God, this is gorgeous, for the message coming through. You know, someone is like, you know, is anybody out there, whatever, blah, 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 hey, 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 sending out the beacon, Morse code, do, 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 and you're over here with the ability, the tools to decipher said code. It's like this is the imprint that you and this other energy share with one another. And this thing is like coming through your wiring and you're like, do, 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 do. Hold on. What is this? What is the message? Oh my God. Okay. And then whatever it is, the interpretation of this message, and like, here you are just in deep deciphering this code, right? I got all that spy imagery of like the invisible ink and like Secret World of Alex Mack. Okay, ghostwriters, you are deciphering what is invisible, what perhaps only you can hear, Aquarius. This whole thing could be about you just like coming into your intuitive gifts in a really big way. But it could also be that there's just like something sticking in me that there's, it's about where you come from. You come from that cluster of stars. And it's like, there's something, it's almost like the size of pineal gland. I realize the pineal gland is not at the base of the sternum. What's that called? Manubrium. I realize that's not where the pineal gland is, but that's sort of what's coming through, is it's like whatever this is that you've encountered or that you're picking up on, it's awakening this dormant pineal gland thing that's right at the core of you, the center of your identity. That's what this chakra here is all about, like your identity, who you are. This is about who you are, Aquarius. And it's just like phew, bursting open in answer to someone else's beacon that has the same thing, or like, you know, your associate star. Whatever that is, whatever that energy is, whether it's like literally a star calling to you, you know, calling you now to awaken. It's like your beacons have focused in, have honed in, and you are attuning to this frequency. And then that leaves you here. And this card has been coming through. I've been seeing it as like on a new planet, on like a new world, stepping through some sort of invisible doorway, portal, some sort of portal to a new world. And it's like there's new things to be hatched on this world. Okay, there's like new things to grow and hatch and create on this planet with your like compass. Okay, this is a compass because it's about direction, the direction you're going in. Oh my god, okay, this is such a big deal, this revelation coming in. It's really incredible. So, and it's actually, now that I think about it, kind of similar to your October shift reading, which was like something is surfacing, you know, like the crocodile image that I got, this like crocodile surfacing and its eye. I'm gonna try to do a hand puppet thing. Crocodile, be the rest of it. Crocodile surfacing and its eye opening. Aquarius, good God. I'm going to continue this in an extended reading. All right. Flower essences. Wow. Okay. I'm going to see where this is going. If this is resonating with you and you are interested in the extended, stick around. There'll be a little clip at the end of this where you can get a preview and see if it's continuing to resonate with you. If it is, click the link below. Follow me over to Vimeo. You can have access to that instantly. All right. Thank you so much, Aquarius, for sharing this incredible energy with me. I feel like I'm just like buzzing all over. It's so beautiful. So thanks for letting me into your frickin' cosmic wild world over here, Aquarius. Take care of yourself. I'll talk to you soon. Okay, epiphany, separate, healing. Epiphany, Ace of Swords. This is the transmission coming through. Morse code, you're deciphering it. It hits your like pineal gland at the core of you, and you just, you now see the healing work perhaps that you need to do within yourself, for the collective, and who you need to do it with. Look, there's more than one person in this image. They're working together on this healing. And that is requiring you, in order to go do this, there is something, a cycle that you have to close. Ten of Wands, and I'm getting that, that this is associated with separate. It could be a couple of things. It could be that you are currently separate from your other people that you're working with or whatever, whatever, but it feels more like in order to flow down, you know, to flow where the river is trying to take you, where the river, where the water, where the intuitive waters, the emotional waters are trying to take you home, is what I wanted to say, to your home planet, your home stars. Oh shit, the star is in this epiphany card, and the whole, like, all those stars, that there's your associate star. Pew. Beacon, like a beacon beaming, and you're like, I get it. And so there's something that you have to let go of to complete something, like soul contracts, essentially, that you have, that you are now being guided to complete this. You essentially, it's saying, Aquarius, you have completed this. Like, I'm almost hearing applause. It's gorgeous. Like, you have completed this. Well done. All of this feels like this. And now it's time for you to keep flowing. This is you, in case that wasn't clear.